Alamance County is pleased to present the Alamance County Commissioners Meeting.
As we live on a planet that's got many stresses economically, militarily, politically, help mankind solve its problems for peace so that it can endure. Amen.
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 I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
This meeting will come to order. Since we have nobody signed up to talk to us this morning, we will go ahead and start the meeting and continue on. Does the commissioners have anything to say? Open the meeting with any suggestions, ideas, comments.
I want to recognize that fellow right there and see if he has anything to say, Mr. Chairman.
David Smith wants to know if you have anything to say, if you'd like to stand up and...
I'd just like to thank everybody with the county for their thoughts and prayers and cards. It's been a long trip, but we made it, and it's good to be back, and I'm ready to jump back anyway.
We're glad you're back.
Thank y'all so much, everybody.
The next item on the list will be the consent agenda. Does anybody look at your consent agenda and see if there's any item in there that needs to be taken out and talked about or discussed?
I want A to be pulled. A out-of-state travel request.
Anybody else have anything that needs to be pulled? Okay. The rest of the agenda. Oh, you want to talk about it before we... vote on the whole agenda. You want to vote on the agenda now, the consent agenda.
I'm not going to say too much about it anyway. I just can't. I can't see paying $4,000 to send two people to Washington D.C. for a seminar that to me is absolutely ridiculous. And I won't vote for that particular one. I have no problem with the rest of them.
Anybody else?
Can we get some commentary on it from?
They're on the list to speak
about that.
After the consent agenda, they're the first ones on the list. Okay. And they're both of them are here.
Harrison.
To talk.
We can vote on the consent.
Okay,
we can.
Is there a motion to approve the consent agenda?
Without that.
Separate.
Without item A.
So.
Okay. All those in favor, say aye.
Aye.
All those opposed. The ayes have it. Okay, let's talk about A. Out-of-state travel request, health department. Do y'all want to wait? You want to table that until we hear from the health department?
Sure.
Okay, we're going to go to the number six item. The introduction of the department's spotlight on the initiative, county management. That's something else.
Yes, sir.
We want to.
Thank you, Mr. Vice Chairman. We recently had our department head retreat, and one of the things that came out of that department head retreat was a willingness and a wanting for all departments to really let the board know what they do. And because there's a lot of different intricacies that each department does, a lot of different programs the board may be unaware that they do. We have 26 departments that work for Alamance County. And the thought process that we had is that for each of our board meetings is to allow 10 minutes as part of that meeting for each department to come forward, make a presentation about, statistics on what they do, about personnel, about programs they do, really to help educate the board on things that they do, but also to help educate the general public about programs that they may not know that's available. So with the board's approval, we're going to spotlight a department at each meeting. Again, take about 10 minutes to kind of give them a chance to shine, but also share some very good information with the board as well.
I think that's a great idea.
What will the selection process be?
All have agreed to do it. It would be, if you like some before the others, we can, but all have agreed to do it. So we were just going to go who had something ready. Like this month, the Board of Health was celebrating their 75th anniversary, so we thought they would be a perfect opportunity to start with them.
Okay.
But we would do everything from environmental, you know, not everything from veteran services, sheriff's department, to planning, you name it, we would do the whole gamut of departments, Board of Elections.
You don't need a motion for that, do you?
No, sir, just want to make sure Okay. That was a consensus that you know what's coming.
Does everybody approve of that? Is this a consensus?
I don't have a problem.
Okay, good. I think the information is important to have. The next item on the list, presentation, 75 years of public health, Alamance County, and proclamation, the health department staff. A.O. White and Tara Yancey. Did I say those names right? Are they here? Welcome. We're glad y'all are here.
Thank you. Good morning. My name is Tiara Yancey, health educator.
And my name is Aya White, registered nurse.
And we represent the Alamance County Health Department. We're honored to present the history of the health department in celebration of 75 years of public health in our county. We hope that we leave you today with one clear message. Public health has a proud history of success in finding effective solutions to the problems that are most important to our county. And we continue this legacy today as we respond to difficult health challenges. 75 years ago, the population of Alamance County was 71,000 residents with a life expectancy of 64 years. Infectious diseases and complications of childbirth were the top two contributors to death of residents.
Today, our population has more than doubled, and our residents' life expectancy has increased by 13 years. Public health measures taken by our department have significantly decreased. Many infectious diseases and maternal deaths have become a rarity. Our department's focus has shifted towards addressing health across the lifespan, which also presents a variety of complex challenges. We are excited to share with you the history of our health department and where we plan to go in the future. So what is public health? Public health, according to the 1920 definition, Winslow, is the science of art of preventing diseases, prolonging life, promoting health through the organized efforts and informed choices of society, organizations, communities, and individuals.
In the 1930s, if you ask the residents of Alamance County what were some of the biggest issues, they will likely reply, the poor economy, the complications present at childbirth, and the infectious diseases such as tuberculosis and smallpox. The Alamance County Health Department was founded to address these urgent needs, and community support grew for this new concept of public health. In 1938, the health department was established. In the first year of operation, 10,000 children were vaccinated against smallpox. Typhoid clinics were established in the counties, in the schools countywide, and tuberculosis follow-ups were being provided in the county. Shown here is a mobile tuberculosis clinic and a health department inspector investigating a backyard privy. This gives insight into the department's attempt to eradicate infectious diseases in the community.
In the 1940s brought the Second World War, an increase in the services and size of the health department. The organizations provided blood tests to the county men drafted into the military, established an STD clinic treating approximately 300 people weekly, received a grant to establish a children's clinic and general clinic in Saxophone Hall, and with assistance from the U.S. Public Health Service, addressed and eradicated ringworm epidemic in the county school system. By the 1950s, the services provided by the health department continued to expand. Not only did the Board of the Commissioners approve the remodeling and expansion of the health department, but also more comprehensive public health services were available to residents. The health department expanded the number of STD clinics, increased the vaccinations for communicable diseases, gave more physical examination and dental exams for help for school children, offered sanitation programs, gave restaurant inspections, and began addressing mental health in the county. The health department also followed the fundamentals of public health by making efforts to improve the health and life expectancies of all people and provided services regardless of race and economic standings.
In the 1960s, the health department focused on increasing sanitation, tobacco use, and improving health education. Locally, the focus certainly shifted from a treatment to a prevention model in regards to infectious and chronic diseases. In 1964, the Alamance County Family Planning Clinic was started where families could learn about better managing their fertility. At the end of the 1960s, the county opened the first sanitary landfill and started its first supplemental food program. In the 1970s, the newly established Family Planning Clinic became well supported in the county and was seen as one of the most important services offered to residents. Additionally, with an increase in vaccines administered, the health department switched from sterilizing reusable syringes to using disposable syringes for more sanitary administration. They were making every attempt possible to reduce transmission of infectious diseases.
Emerging health concerns at the state and national level in the 1980s resulted in the local focus shift in public health priorities from treatment of infectious diseases to primary prevention. An increase in obesity led to the need for nutritional programs, and increases in tobacco use led to public policy restrictions placed on smoking. Educational programs directed at teens were started to address increasing teen pregnancy. These are just several examples of how the health department responded toward newly emerging health concerns. In the 1990s, new vaccines such as hepatitis A and hepatitis B and varicella were available to residents at the health department relocated to the Human Service Center on North Graham Hopedale Road. The Healthy Alamance Initiative was established on the partnership. One of the first tasks was the funding of Substance Abuse Task Force in 1997 to prevent underage drinking. In 1998, the Alamance Children's Dental Health Center was established to provide dental services for children 0 to 21 years of age.
Moving forward into the 21st century, the Health Department received state accreditation. Early in the 21st century, several prevention programs were established using grant funding, and these programs began to focus on health across the lifespan. The Teen Outreach Program was founded. TOP is a comprehensive life skills program designed to reduce risk factors that can lead to teen pregnancy, violence, gang involvement, and other antisocial behaviors. Centering pregnancy was implemented. Breastfeeding peer education and medical nutrition therapy started in WIC. There were also a few environmental changes as well that went into effect in 2010. The House Bill 2, which prohibited smoking in certain places like restaurants, and House Bill 88, also known as the Healthy Youth Act. The health department staff were heavily involved, acting as a resource to our schools to ensure a smooth implementation process.
In 2011, funding was awarded to the Health Department for Project Launch. The goal of this program was to create a preventive system of care for children under age eight years old and their families by screening and identifying potential concerns in physical, social, emotional, cognitive, and behavioral health.
In 2012, the Health Department was challenged with a rapidly spreading pertussis epidemic. Several strategies were used to address pertussis. The Health Department responded as the lead agency. However, we worked closely with other community agencies to identify, treat, and prevent cases. Also in 2012, Healthy Homes was established in the county. Healthy Homes is a coordinated response program to prevent serious illnesses among children with asthma.
Today, Alamance County residents can utilize a variety of resources, such as HIV and AIDS testing, pregnancy care management, child health, care coordination for children, communicable disease prevention, children's dental care, environmental health, family planning, immunizations, maternal care, school health outreach, STD prevention, treatment and education, health education, WIC services, public health preparedness. As you can see, our goal throughout the 75 years has certainly been to promote healthy children to grow into healthy adults in order to become healthy citizens. Prevention truly pays off in that each dollar spent on family planning efforts saves more than $3 in public costs. Each dollar invested in childhood immunizations saves more than $18 that would otherwise be spent on treatment. Each dollar invested in community water fluoridation, $38 is saved on in unnecessary dental treatments costs. Every dollar spent on pregnant women in WIC produces $1.92 to $4.21 in Medicaid savings for newborns and their mothers. Every dollar spent on child safety seats saves $32 direct medical costs and other costs to society. Our hope is that individuals can live, work, pray, play in our community.
Thank you for your time today. We hope that we have conveyed our message of providing, partnering, protecting, preventing, and promoting throughout the community well. We have a successful history to celebrate, and as issues continue to emerge, we can take pride in the fact that our health department can be thought of as a lead resource, but a helpful resource in solving serious health issues. We are grateful for this chance to celebrate with you all a strong public health system over the past 75 years. And we are excited about our next 75 years of excellence. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Does one of you want to read the your proclamation? Barry, you want to read it, or you want me to?
I can read it.
Thank you, Mr. Okay. Proclamation for Public Health Month 2013 by the Board of Commissioners, County of Alamance, North Carolina. Proclamation. Whereas we hereby recognize and acknowledge 75 years of public health service to the residents of Alamance County and the immeasurable contribution of these services to the quality of life in our communities. And whereas Alamance County Health Department is a critical component of the county's emergency response to natural and man-made disasters and the widespread disease outbreaks in our community. And whereas public health measures are an efficient and effective use of public health resources and control to eliminate infectious diseases, improve environmental sanitation, and promote the healthy lifestyles practices, and have been the greatest cause of improvement in health and increased life expectancy in Alamance County residents. And whereas the Alamance County Board of Health exercises statutory duties and oversight and policy development to assure the protection and improvement of the public's health. Whereas Alamance County Health Department, more than 2,300 food and lodging, institutional child care, public health swimming pool and tattoo facility inspections each year to protect public from disease, and annually contributes more than $33.2 million to our local economy through WIC nutrition program for young families, and in 2012 served 3,095 children with our dental care who may not have otherwise afforded it. Whereas a continued focus on the promoting public health programs that provides access, high-quality medical care that promote healthy lifestyles for women of childbearing age has resulted in more than a 23% decline in infant mortality. Whereas a continued focus on prevention has resulted in more than 17% in the decline in the adjusted age-adjusted heart disease rates in the past 10 years, a more than 18% decline in the age-adjusted stroke death rates in the last 10 years, and a 41% decline in the teen pregnancy rate since 2007. And whereas a continued focus on prevention has tangible economic benefits for taxpayers, and that the dollar spent in family planning efforts results more than $3 in public costs, each dollar invested in childhood immunizations saves more than $18 that would otherwise be spent on treatment, and for every dollar spent on child safety seats, the $32 in direct medical costs and other costs to society. Now therefore, we, the Board of Commissioners for County of Alamance, do hereby proclaim April 2013 is Public Health Month in Alamance County, and urge our citizens to recognize that public health is working to ensure that the residents of Alamance County are protected from such formidable threats as influenza, foodborne disease, and cardiovascular disease, and in witness whereof, set forth in the hand Alamance County, North Carolina, the first day of April, year of our Lord 2013, and independence of the United States of America, 2037.
Thank you, Barry.
Yes, sir.
Very good.
Can I ask you a question? Could you tell us what department?
Oh, absolutely. I was going to introduce just do some the whole our whole crew for you.
Just sign your name underneath there.
Rebecca Russo works in our environmental health department. She is an environmental health specialist. And Candace Jeffries works in a WIC program. She's one of our nutritionists. I White is our communicable disease nurse, and she was kind of front and center during our pertussis outbreak. Terry Ansey is our health educator, who works in the TOPS program, as you've seen earlier, with the middle school kids in terms of trying to prevent pregnancy, working towards responsible behaviors, risks so kids won't get involved in smoking and drinking and gangs and other kinds of bad health behaviors. And then back in the back, we've got Jenna Elliott, who is just kind of hiding. She's our administrative officer, but she's also been involved with our program. So,
let's clap.
You ladies done a good job representing the health board or health department. And I was on the health board 12 years, and it is an interesting board. Just a lot goes on there. We're glad you're here.
Thank you.
Let's go back and talk about the travel.
Yes, sir.
This is, the proper time since Barry's
at the podium. Mr. Vice Chair, do you want to adopt the proclamation?
We want to make a motion to adopt the proclamation.
So moved. I'll second it. Well, either way, it don't matter.
All those in favor, say aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, and there are none, proclamation is declared.
Thank you. Greatly appreciate it. To address Commissioner Smith's questions, this particular travel relates back to a Project Launch, which is our childhood behavioral health program that we've recently been funded in the last 2 years. The funds to pay for the travel were included in the grant. Part of the grant requirements under this is that we have to participate in the national training every year. So it's a training event that allows our staff to go up and not only learn about evidence-based practices that are currently being used across the country, but also to talk about the great program that we've done here in Alamance County. We are the statewide implementation site. The actual grantee from the feds is North Carolina, and then Alamance County is the statewide implementation site for the state. And we have done an incredible job of implementation here. We have taken the lead in the Triple P, which is a positive parenting program. We're recognized as the best site in North Carolina in implementation of that. So this will allow our two ladies to go and, one, toot our horn about the great job that we're doing here in Alamance County, and also learn about what's going on in other parts of our country. There are like 26 of these projects throughout the United States. So then we can, in turn, bring back the good things that are going on in other places and implement here. This is, this is part of the grant requirement. We accepted the grant, and the funds to cover the cost of the travel were included with the budget that was approved for 2012-13.
What was the total grant?
Right now, it is somewhere around $470,000. But we did receive an additional $100,000 because we had been doing such a good job with Triple P. We got an extra $100,000. So again, the state has recognized the good job that Alamance County has been doing.
And you got the grant when?
Actually, we started 2 years ago. So we're,
and you, we approved your application for
yes,
the grant.
Yes, sir, absolutely.
Is it a part, SAMHSA, am I pronouncing that right?
SAMHSA.
SAMHSA. I love acronyms. But they're heavily involved in this. They're speaking at the meeting. They're giving opening remarks. I mean, is this all related?
Well, that's the interesting part. The part that Susan and our child welfare program does with our through the system of care is based on intervention and treatment, and the project launch is based on prevention. So our focus is trying to, one, educate the community about the behavioral health issues, and then again be a resource, an early, you know, we can do early identification with children so that they don't wind up, you know, in the families wind up in situations where they're needing more intervention. So it's trying to find, if there are behavioral health issues early, if there are issues with the family, if they've got things going on such as substance abuse or what, we try to work with the families prior to, and it looks holistically at the family.
But so it's separate from
yes,
the social services grant.
It's a different. It's the same overall part of the federal government, if you will, but it is a separate program. Yes, sir. Entirely different. Again, they work on intervention and treatment, and Project Launch is working on prevention.
How long will you, the grants for 400 some thousand, how long will that last?
Well, we've got one more year left, and based on the fact that we got it late, as you may remember, it was initially started in Guilford County. We inherited, if you will, and we probably, with the transition, are going to get one more year out of it.
So yeah, I remember the question coming up. Why did Guilford not want it? Why did they?
Well, it was basically that they were having difficulty in doing their implementation. There were changeovers, I think, the administration of how the grant was being funded.
They had kept it a couple of years.
Yes, sir. They had done it 1 year and looking at the second, and that's when we were asked to take the grant. And it's really been, I think, a real blessing and benefit to our community.
And when it runs out, what do you do?
Well, that's part of what we're working on now, and that's part of what this training will do, is looking at sustainability. To look for other kinds of grants in other places and other opportunities where funding may be available.
And one thing that the board agreed upon when we accepted the grant is that we would not guarantee personnel past the lifespan of the grant. So when the grant runs out, the county is not obligated to take that personnel onto county staff. So. Just to make you remind you of that as well, is that this is solely grant funding and not county dollars involved in this.
That's correct.
Director Bass, I'm not opposed to you and your staff. You do a great job, really,
sure.
And I'm proud of the Alamance County Health Department. Grants to me are taxes. It's tax money, and I'm just totally beginning to be opposed to all of these grants because there are always strings attached, and I don't like a lot of the strings that I read, and I don't intend to. I will consider any that come before me, but I cannot vote for this. It may be a good deal or not. I don't know. I don't read it in the agenda, but I still support you and your staff. Always will.
Is there any other discussion concerning out of trouble, or do I have a motion?
I make a motion to put it back on the
okay.
On the consent agenda.
I'll second that.
Okay.
All those in favor of the passing of item, the consent agenda, including A, out-of-state travel requests, Health Department.
Aye.
Aye. Thank you, Brian.
No.
I'm sorry. All those opposed?
No.
Okay, the next item will be a report from our county manager, Craig Honeycutt.
Thank you, Mr. Vice Chair. Just a couple things I wanted to mention is remind you of our budget retreat, which is in 2 weeks, which will be April 15th at 9:30 at May Memorial. We do plan to have budget books available midweek that week that we will be delivering to you. So we're in the process of getting all that information together. Follow up on the budget, one of the requests at our last meeting was to relook at some of our expenditures. What we did after that meeting is we sat down with HR and also with the department heads, looked at some open positions. We were able to freeze some. We also put a halt on expenditures unless they were deemed necessary, such as pens and pencils and paper, for the operation of the county government. So we've cut those expenditures as well. We also cut travel unless it was necessary for certification or approved, you know, as part of training. But again, overnight travel now has to be approved by the county manager, even in state. And the conferences that we have that I think is the conferences that are optional, they are not approved of at this time. So we have, you know, I think our department heads have done an excellent job this year of holding back expenditures, but I think there was a concern amongst the board, and I agree with that concern, is that even though our margin says we will be in the black this year, it's a thin margin. We need to ensure that we stay in the black this year and not use fund balance. If there's any questions about that.
Anyone have any questions?
At the budget retreat, are the department heads giving their wish list, or are they giving us a bare bones budget that they can get by on? Or?
The wish list will be in your book of additional capital and additional personnel. And the department heads will be at the meeting and be able to ask or answer any questions that you may have. We haven't done really or set up a lot of presentations in the past for department heads because it has been so bare bones, you know, that they fully understand we're not putting in new personnel. They fully understand we're not putting in new capital, even though it'll be listed. That is basically a continuation budget, a continuation of operations. It's not anything, you know, trying to put in new programs or new personnel. But they will be there. We will have it broken out so you can see. And if you have specific questions, you know, they'll be there to answer them. But basically, you know, the way we've told departments about this year's budget, it's got to be at this year's, you know, they'll probably get this year's level or less. So, but they will be there if you have questions. Yes, sir. Or if you have specific people you would like to have presentations or hear from, let us know early and we can make sure they make a presentation.
Are you going to do it by department? Are we going over it by department or what?
Well, just a general overview. We will show you, you know, requests, expenditure, you know, revenues, expenditures, you know, where we're at in the red. Here's personnel that's been requested, you know, a total number of personnel, and have that broken down. Here's capital that's broken down. And kind of show you some trends of what we've been seeing over the past few years. Yes, sir.
You say capital. You're talking about revenue?
No, capital expenditures. Vehicles, equipment, those type things. But we'll have all that broken down.
That's right.
do want to mention a couple of things. Number one, I do want to thank the departments and also Vice Chairman Lashley for showing up at the Providence Church, and appreciate you representing the board there. We had over 20 staff members at their celebration. It was a county celebration. They gave up their Sunday afternoon in a wet, rainy Sunday afternoon to participate. Appreciate Brian coordinating that for the county end. Very appreciative from Reverend Peoples, and very appreciative from their congregation that was there. And I think we had a good time as well. So, you know, we do appreciate that opportunity to go out to the public when asked, and we did a great job, and just very proud of the work that was done. So, Brian, you got anything?
No. Yeah, that went real well. That was a good presentation for on the behalf of the county. And Brian and y'all's staff did a good job.
Is there any written material in regards to the history of that church? And the location, I think it was first courthouse.
A lot of
yes, Reverend Peoples shared some information with me. If you'd like, I can email it to you.
If you would, yeah, I like to see.
It's really interesting, the history. 250 years in that location, they were here before the county. And
I have family that's
everything. All the history started at Providence Church. A lot of history.
And also, at the same time, we had the portrait unveiling for the judges at the courthouse, and I appreciate what Richard did as well on that. We had to kind of split our time up a little bit, so I spent part of my time at Providence and then part of my time at the courthouse. But both events went really, really well, and was an opportunity to showcase the county staff and county facilities. So,
thank you.
Next, I do want to mention is a plug for our department heads. We had our department head retreat a couple of weeks ago, and part of that retreat, we worked for Habitat for Humanity for half a day, and it was a wonderful opportunity for us. Appreciate Bruce Walker setting up that with Habitat for us, but it was really a good opportunity for department heads to see each other on a different level, and also to get out and work together and truly remember what public service is. So I do appreciate the work that our department heads did. And I do want to remind you of our lunch on April 11th with the Farm Bureau at 11:30 a.m. that it starts at the Iron Gate Winery. And that is all I have.
Okay, does any commissioners have any comments?
I'd like to ask, I wasn't planning on doing this today, but I think it's apropos. And might ease the stress on my back. My back's been killing me here the last couple of days. What is the process for requesting information? Public, what is it called?
Public records request.
Public record. Well, yeah. What's the process for that?
You contact the person that you're seeking the public records from, and they provide them to you within a reasonable time.
Now, who does that?
Well, I do a lot of it. Most of them are referred to me. Well, the county. You know, other departments may handle it differently. But usually the health
what's
department.
What's it called? Public records request. Well, I'm going to go ahead. Like I said, I wasn't planning on doing this morning, but it's apropos, I think, for everything that's happened lately here. For 3 months, I've been trying to get Alamance Burlington School System to give me information that I believe they have in printed form. And the way this came about was I accidentally stumbled across a statistic that the Center for Disease Control in Atlanta, it's no right-wing organization, no conspiratorial agency or group of people, they have a report that shows that North Carolina, let me preface it with one more thing. I think that citizens, let alone elected officials, even though it's something they might not be able to affect,
if there's something we think that's out there that needs to be discussed and it's not being discussed, that would benefit the citizens of this county, that we have an obligation to do so, especially when it comes to children. And that's what this is all about. The Center for Disease Control in Atlanta has a report that says North Carolina has the highest rate in the United States by far. Nobody's even close in the field of attention deficit disorder. So my ears perk up. Why? I was at a meeting when I first asked the first question. Well, I think I had gone through the school board, and the chairman of the school board, Tony Rose, basically told me he wasn't going to help me. He said he didn't think there was a problem. He didn't know of a problem. I guess he thought Alamance County was out on another planet. And he basically gave me a couple of names of people to talk to. And I did. Got very little rhetoric. I got a lot of rhetoric, very few efficiently returned phone calls, and so on and so on. It was almost like I was asking something taboo or something they just didn't want to respond to. And worse yet, they weren't aware of the statistic. Now, I was at a meeting of juvenile crime prevention, and I wasn't going to ask the question that I asked when I went in. Didn't have any idea I was going to ask it. But there was a practitioner there that works with children, works with parents, Medicaid approved. I asked her. She was given a program. And after it was over with, she said, "Are there any questions?" And I thought, well, yeah. Looked like the window had been open for me. And I thought, yeah, I'll go ahead and ask. I said, "Are you aware of this statistic?" She said, "No." And I said, "Well, is it a good stat? Bad stat? What is it? Why do you think it's that high?" She didn't blink an eye. She turned and looked at me, and she said, "This isn't public now. This is a public meeting." She said, "I think the schools push it to keep the fidgety kids quiet." That was her exact reply. And I said, "So do I." Well, the assistant superintendent for exceptional children sitting across the room. And I thought I saw a defensive wall go up. He said, "Well, we don't diagnose anybody. We don't write prescriptions." And I said, "Yeah, but do you push it?" Not much of a reply. I have stayed on this for 3 months, and it's stunning how I've been treated over this issue. I was over in Greensboro, killing time before I went to the school I go to, and I was at Embassy Suites Hotel. And I walked through the lobby, and there was a table there where they were having a seminar, getting ready to have a seminar. And I didn't pay attention to it because they have them all the time. I walked by and got to the easel, and there was this big placard. And it had something about exceptional children. So I turned around and went back. I thought, aha. So a lady was there, and I said, "Can you get somebody to come out here and talk to me about this?" And she said, "Sure." So she went to a private room where they were meeting, and before the meeting was to start. This was a statewide meeting. She came out, and she was with DPI. And I asked her, I said, "Are you aware of this statistic?" She said, "No." She was shocked. Said she had no idea. And I didn't know if she was shooting me a line or not. We talked roughly 30 minutes. She had better not get into giving any more information about her. But she had an adult son on attention deficit disorder. So she was concerned and so forth and so on. So, I didn't know if she was being sincere or not, but I just wanted to get the information out to her, see how she reacted, and I walked on. So I went to the place I go to over there, and some people I know, and I was time for me to leave, and I was walking back by her table, and I was going out the door. I wasn't even going to say any more to her. She turned away. She was in a group of women, and she turned to me and grabbed me verbally, and she said, "What did you say that stat was?" And I said, 15.6%. And horror just was on her face, and she turned to the group of people she was with, and they were disgusted. I mean, I have been told that DPI doesn't know the stat was that high, our local officials don't know it's that high, our school board doesn't know it's that high. People in the administrative office over here, Dr. Hussey and the head of exceptional children, Thorpe, he didn't know it was that high. So I've been asking for the written policy, written procedures that I believe exist on how to handle children that are in need, inclusive of attention deficit disorder. They are leading me to believe that, first of all, the insinuation was, innuendo was, the parents do it before they even come to the school. Schools don't have anything to do with it. Well, bull. And number two, the innuendo is that there is no policy. Bull. There's no way that a teacher can deal with these students without there being some hoops that they go through for the interview process with the parent, with the child, with recommendations and so forth. Now, I'm going to try to go ahead and cut this off. I think my request is out there, but I was talking to the Department of Human Services in Raleigh. Susan Robinson did an unbelievable email back to me about how the CDC came about the stat and the study. It's nationwide, just what, North Carolina. And she sent it to me. I sent that email to Superintendent Cox, the secretary, and I said, I want this sent to every school board member and everybody involved. I sent them a New York Times article that was printed on the front page of the Raleigh News Observer about a 22-year-old boy that went to Greensboro College and committed suicide. And his parents said that he was just wrecked with this medicine and that he never needed to be put on it. Wall Street Journal, two articles. Wall Street Journal's doing articles on this. Sent three articles, the study from the Department of Health and Human Services out of Raleigh. Everybody got it. I got no phone calls back. I got no response, period. That's sad. That's sad. Lastly, last week, a professor at Duke Medical Center who heads up the Attention Deficit Disorder program at Duke, and they're studying, they treat it. I'm not saying nobody needs to be treated with this, but I think it's possibly excessive and pushed. He called me back and he said, your phone calls to me could not be more timely. This is coming from Duke Medical Center. I said, well, sir, I wished my school board or my school administration felt the same way. And he laughed. He said, I can only imagine. That was his very reply. I can only imagine. He said, they were aware of the stat. That was the only person I've talked to in 3 months at all the levels that knew the stat was that high, Duke Medical Center. And he said, we want to know why. He said, there's something out there that nobody's talking about. We need to find out what's going on. And he said, your phone call could not be more timely in that there had just been a study released last week. He said he didn't buy into it totally, if at all. But he said, I'm going to send it to you. They did a study that said that they concluded that solar intensity, the code was SI, the solar intensity rates all across the United States seem to correlate AD, attention deficit disorder rates. But he laughed. He said, I don't necessarily buy that. And so long story short, I feel like I've been given the runaround. I feel like I've been sidetracked. And actually, I don't think I've had the truth told to me. Now, and I resent that coming from a public agency that receives tax funds that deals with our children in this county. I resent it. Now, lastly, I know for a fact, that an elementary school nurse told me there was a policy, there is a procedure. She also told me that the children at certain levels are given fidget boards. The word fidgety comes out in all this debate. Even when you look at the symptoms for attention deficit disorder, one of the symptoms that they list will be they're fidgety. As that woman told me when I asked her, she said, I think they push it to keep the fidgety kids quiet. That's exact. Oh, and in that meeting, her counterpart from Charlotte, her supervisor, whose credentials are, she got her undergraduate from Temple and her master's from Boston University. I accidentally got her on the phone thinking it was the lady that I had asked that question. And I wanted to apologize to that lady for putting her on the spot, but I want to thank her for being brutally honest. And I had the wrong woman on the phone. And when I realized I had the wrong woman, I apologized for that. But I went ahead and said, well, ma'am, let me ask you a question. Do you agree with how she replied? She said, most definitely. Most definitely. Now, in this phone call to the nurse, who says there is a policy, there are hoops they go through, and it is written, she told me, that I can see it. That was her believing I was a grandparent. Well, I am a grandparent of a child and a sister, but she didn't know who I was. I'll be blunt about it and say, honest about it, she didn't know who I was. I think if she had known who I was, I wouldn't have got what she told me. And that's sad. She said they give them fidgety boards, and I act like I didn't hear that or didn't understand what a fidget board was. Then she told me, and we can give them a weighted vest. Yes, it is funny. Yet you've got professionals out there that swear it works. They swear it works. But I'm sure you've got some that say it's silly too. And I said, and then finally I came back around to the fidget board, and I said, what's a fidget board? That's something they put on the floor and they put their feet on it. It's something to keep them in their seat, I suppose. Keep their feet in one location. I'm not sure. But then I said, well, now what about a weighted vest? What is that? And she said, it's exactly what it sounds like. They put on a vest. You can Google it. They put on a vest like a hunter's vest. You got these vests.
Yeah.
You know what I'm talking about. Bulletproof vests and so forth. And it got weights in them. And I said, what's that? What are you trying to do? Hold them in their seat? And I started laughing. She laughed. She said, oh, well, it makes them feel well-balanced and well-rounded and so forth. Now, I don't believe for a moment that a teacher in an elementary school puts a weighted vest on a kid, gives them a fidget board, without a policy of how they got to that final conclusion. In my school system, Alamance Burlington school system, will swear to me there's no such thing. I want to see it. I've spent 3 months asking for it. I've been given the biggest runaround I've ever seen. Now, they're going to swear they're not giving me the runaround. It's like divorce court, I suppose. I've never been to divorce court. But I have been given the biggest runaround I've ever seen, and I'm tired of it. I can send them an email, a phone call, not get a reply for 2 weeks or a week. And I'm tired of it. Fed up with it. I want to see what's written on the books, and I don't want to be referred back to DPI. If DPI's got it, it's in Alamance Burlington on Baldwin Road, as far as what the written policy is of how they handle the interviews, the referrals, the whole nine yards. I'm not making any more phone calls to them, nor emails. If I've abused my role as a commissioner in y'all's eyes that I shouldn't be doing this, I do apologize. But I don't think I have. I'm concerned about our children. They're claiming there are thousands of kids in this county that's got attention deficit disorder. And I'm not saying that we don't have some. But the ratio, I think, probably is higher than it would be because I think there's too much of an effort to push families and children into it. And countless articles are coming out. This is a national debate, and it appears our local people don't want to talk about it. And the articles that are coming out now are saying these kids are on it all their life. How do you get them off of it?
Ritalin.
Well, in a joking fashion, and I'll let it be. Some friends of mine.
Thank you.
We were down in Fayetteville watching some movies one night. Listen to this. You'll love this. And all of a sudden, it was like God just laid this in my lap. Reagan's mother is going to this psychiatrist because of her condition. And this doctor leans back in his chair and he says, well, what we're going to do is prescribe to her something we think will really help her. And I didn't remember this from the old movie. And he said, Ritalin. And I just thought, my God, I don't believe it. I said, look what it did to her. But I've done all I can do, and I think as a county commissioner or a citizen, we have a right to ask these questions and to have some official academic dialogue about it. And you can't have a lot of dialogue if you don't see their policy. And I'd like to request that we ask for it.
Okay. Any other commissioners' comments?
Are you making a motion for the board?
Yes, sir.
I'll second.
Or support. You know,
is there a, do we take a voice vote?
Aye.
All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
All those opposed.
Just to be clear, you're instructing me as the county attorney to request these documents?
Right. Yes. The policies, procedures, anything written that deals with the interviews of the family, the child, the recommendations, the whole process.
To the extent that they're not medical related or medically exempted,
yeah.
I'll ask for them.
Right.
We'll see.
I just have to believe there's a policy that teachers are instructed as to how to handle it.
You're probably right, Ms. Medical.
And they're all but telling me it doesn't exist.
I'll make the request.
Okay. Do we have any commissioners' announcements? Or any announcements?
Yep. My back feels better already.
Okay. With no other business, I'll call this to an end.
Thank you for tuning in to the Alamance County Commissioners meeting. Meetings of the Commissioners Board occur at 7 p.m. on the first and third Monday of each month in the Commissioners' Chambers on the second floor of the County Office Building located at 124 West Elm Street in Graham. Changes to the meeting schedule will be posted on the Commissioners' website at www.alamance-nc.com. You can watch the most recent meeting of the County Commissioners on the second and fourth Wednesday of each month on Time Warner's local public access channel beginning at 10 o'clock p.m. You can also watch recordings of the most recent meeting and past meetings by going to our website at www.alamance-nc.com. Please visit our website for more information on watching commissioner meetings online. For technical questions about this meeting's online or television broadcast, please contact our county webmaster at webmaster@alamance-nc.com. Please note that this address is for technical questions only. Questions or comments regarding the content of commissioner meetings may be made to the commissioners themselves. You can find their contact information at the Alamance County website at www.alamance-nc.com. Click on the link that says Alamance County Commissioners to visit the commissioners website, where you can learn about our commissioners, read minutes of past meetings, access agendas, and find other information about our Board of Commissioners. You can also send mail correspondence to the County Commissioners by addressing it to the Alamance County Commissioners, 124 West Elm Street, Graham, North Carolina, 27253. Again, thank you for tuning in to the Alamance County Commissioners meeting.